Hello, 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 it's the Fat Boy back with episode 2 of a My Team Career Mode series as Benetton, trying to reviving it back towards his championship days. So now here, sorry for getting straight to the point, but we're actually going to change the team colors just a little bit, because in the comment section of the first episode of My Team, someone said that the color scheme was a bit too bright and it was like hurting the eyes. So when I look back at it, I actually felt the same way, so I had to make the colors a bit darker, but still trying to maintain the Benetton B194 colors. So we didn't do that bad, so doing the same thing for the suit. And before we do anything, be sure to like, subscribe and turn on notifications in order not to miss any F1 uploads or uploads of other video games. So it's just seeing that we are going to change the suit and all that, changing the pose, blah blah blah. And we're also going to be changing the team badge colors as well, just to make it correspond with our current logo. So as you can see here, it's a bit tedious, but you will get the job done. So that's it with the team logo. So now it's time to head into our very first F1 Live activity around Saudi Arabia. We're going to do the high speed zone. I think it's called high speed zone if I'm not wrong, instead of the drift activity that we have. No, it's called average speed zone, sorry. So we have to get at least a 156.11 kilometers per hour to get the bronze award, and we'll be using the McLaren 720S, if I'm not wrong. So as you can see here, acceleration is really slow, cars very understeery compared to Formula 1 cars, and we actually overshot the braking zone because I completely forgot at the time that road cars have a lower braking performance than F1 cars, and obviously they need to brake way earlier because they don't have as much mechanical grip as F1 cars. So as you can see here, we're going to try to brake a little bit earlier, just after the 100 meter board. We do lock up just a little bit because obviously I'm not used to road cars kind of braking system, so maybe they're just the same and I just don't have any experience. So as you can see here on the exit, we actually did hit the wall out of the banking, and the car's really understeery, hits the wall there. And we actually hit around 158 kilometers an hour, actually we do. And we just fell short of the silver award. So we're gonna go for one more try, because we only have 3 tries in total. So we're gonna have to give our all if we want to get to the silver award. So as you can see here, this time we do not hit the wall like how we always did at the start, but now we are braking much earlier, but we're still locking up the tires, but we do not go off track limits. So there's still a bit of hope there, but as you can see, the average speed is still dropping because I had a really horrible exit out of the corner. As you can see here, just trying to feather the throttle through. I actually do hit the wall again, but I think that's enough to get silver. Is it? No, we still got bronze with the McLaren 720S. I think we fell short of a few kilometers per hour, so unfortunately, that's the best I can do. I don't feel like restarting the session because obviously the main activity is the F1 stuff, not the F1 Live stuff. So unfortunately, we got the bronze award at best, and it's now time to head into qualifying. So now we're here into qualifying on our very first lap, down the final back straight with DRS open. Verstappen sets the fastest lap, trying to spot the braking point past the 100 meter board, around 80 meters or 75 meters at most. We actually got quite a bit of a decent exit, but I think we did get a bit of wheel spin. Now with DRS open, we cross the line, it's P4, we are just above 7 tenths off of Alonso's timing. And that was actually quite surprising, but obviously we were one of the first to set the lap times. So obviously we knew that we were going to bog down the order. So now we're spotting around 80 meters again into the final corner. This time we got a much cleaner exit, but we could have got closer to the wall a little bit more. So now with DRS open, we cross the line, it's P8, and we are just below 2 tenths off of Alonso. And out of qualifying 1, we are just short of the top 10. But me and Vashaw are through, so this shows that Jeddah is going to be one of our very first opportunities to get points. And obviously we're going to have to make the most out of it. As you can see, both Aston Martins are out, both McLarens are out, because at the time their brakes were really horrible, especially the fronts. And Albon is just clear by a few hundredths of a second. But either way, we are still into Q2. So now, starting our first lap on Q2, P16, because we were the last to set the lap times, breaking just past the 100 meter board, I should say, and we actually got quite a bit of a bad exit here as we actually get wheel spin and we hit the wall, unfortunately. I think the car bottomed out on the curb because the curb was a bit raised at the exit. So that might explain the mishap that we had out of turn 2. Could have gone into Q3, but unfortunately we will be starting from P16 on the grid. Some of our pit crew members obviously very upset with me, as you can see me there walking out of the garage feeling very upset. And unfortunately Richard Vershaw is also out sitting in P14. Charles Leclerc and Carlos Sainz take the first row of the grid in Q2. And we are now at the bottom of Q2, so we'll be starting from 16th place in the race. One of our best opportunities to get into Q3 and score some real points, some huge points maybe if you're lucky. But unfortunately we of course had to crash. So unfortunately that is all for qualifying. Could have done better there on the exit, maybe a bit more careful with the throttle. But now we're just gonna have to keep our head up because it's time for the race, and I'll see you on the grid for race day.
We're here today on the shores of the Red Sea in the Lower Hejaz Mountains to visit one of the newest circuits on the Formula One calendar. We're in Jeddah, home to what we all hope is going to be a thrilling Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. So let's take a look at the topographical map of the Jeddah Street Circuit. As you can see, a number of challenging corners for the drivers to master here. We'll see just how much the teams have benefited from their time spent in practice this weekend. And like many street circuits, this track has the potential to punish drivers that get it wrong. Let's hope we avoid any safety cars today. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. A fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday, and it's put him on pole, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Sainz, Perez, and Sir Lewis Hamilton, and Russell, Bottas, Fernando Alonso, Ocon, and Pierre Gasly, Mick Schumacher, Magnussen, Yuki Tsunoda, and Richard Vershaw, Albon, Black Mamba, Sebastian Vettel, and Guan Yu Zhou, Ricciardo, Stroll, Norris, and Nicholas Latifi. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It'll keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
Hopefully we don't screw up on the second lap just like we did in the last race, which obviously screwed our entire race. Okay, 11 laps on the mediums, 14 laps on the hards. We're gonna overfuel the car just a little bit, and alrighty. Actually, you know, we'll just bring it by an extra lap because if we go for an overcut, obviously some. Actually, no, this is not a very technical race. This is not technical track, not as technical as Bahrain, so I don't think the overcut will be as effective as I think it would be. So I guess normal strategy.
We're not seeing any technical issues coming off the practice starts. Watch the RPM.
Alright, let's get a good one. Come on. Yeah, that's a good job.
Parking there, mate.
Good
let's
job.
Make sure we get the edge on the surrounding drivers as the lights go out.
Purple parking spot. Here come the five red lights for the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. And it's lights out and away we go. Yes. Not that good of a start. We're already getting jumped by Guan Yu Zhou anytime soon. Oh, going for the lunge. Three wide with Vershaw, and I think that's Albon. Or Tsunoda. Yeah, it's Tsunoda. If we have any chance of getting points, this is the one and only race because we're so high up the grid. Oh, a bit of understeer. Got a bit wide. No point fighting Tsunoda because we'll lose time to Vershaw and it's only the first lap. Oh my god, we're getting jumped by Albon anytime soon. He has a slipstream and it's all over my rear wing as well. But the only good thing is that we have a lot of straight line speed, so it should recover some of the lost time. But the Williams is also a very fast car on the straights. Charles Leclerc with the fastest opening lap, obviously in a pole position, so clean air, no interference.
Come on, push hard. Okay, the gap is less than a second. They're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are just
They're certainly getting held up.
We think they've got one more stop. Your last lap time was
Alonso has damage.
40.7.
No, he doesn't have damage. Now Magnussen's going side by side, I think.
Okay, DRS will be enabled this lap. When you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS.
Oh my god, two people going side by side, holding everyone up. Oh, heading into these fast corners, they are going to lose a lot of time. If this was Monaco, we'll be held up quite a lot. Oh, Gasly a bit loose, around the outside. Tsunoda's still there. Yes.
That brings you up a place.
Gasly got a little bit loose there. Now Tsunoda side by side with Zhou Guan Yu. Yeah, Zhou Guan Yu. Okay. For sure, you're right there. Come on. Come on, Richard. Play second driver. Oh, we have so much overspeed on the other cars ahead. A little bit of understeer at the apex. Alonso and Magnussen. No, it's Ocon, sorry. It was Ocon. Yeah, it's Ocon. Ocon and Magnussen side by side! Oh my god, he locks up! Oh, Vershaw almost hits us. Oh, that was really close.
Come on, we need to get past.
Oh my god, everyone's fighting. Oh, got a bit wide, heading to turn one a bit too deep. Oh, Vershaw's right there, we had a horrible exit. Vershaw, get out of the way, I don't lose time to you. Schumacher and Gasly going side by side. Oh, they bang wheels. Oh, around the outside! Oof! Oh! A bit too deep!
Brilliant, nice move. Keep going.
Obviously, we do not have... We only have one downforce upgrade. Oh man, Schumacher's got the overspeed. Oh, we banged tires. He goes a bit defensive heading into the final corner. Oh, he got loose.
We're approaching the pit window now, and you're going to be on hard next time.
Oh, a bit tighter.
Time last lap was a 1:33.7. Okay, they're building a lead of 0.6 a lap. Come on.
Oh, Schumacher's there.
Tire condition still looking good.
Why are you turning into me, why did I call you Michael? Oh my god. Why did you turn into me? We're not gonna box.
Okay, no issues with tire wear for now. Keep taking care of them.
We're gonna bring our tires by two more laps. Box.
Right, let's have you in at the end of this lap, please.
We did have a bit of a lockup. Okay, that's a good turn in. Oh, we had an issue! Not again!
We had an issue removing the right rear wheel. I know it's not ideal, but let's try and put that behind us now and get back into this race.
And we have damage now. We crossed the pit exit white line. No, no. Ah.
Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now.
Wait, is that Ocon? No, it's Schumacher. Oh my lord. Give me the space, man. This race. I can't get the power down because I'm not getting wheel spin for cold tires. We would have been comfortably ahead of Schumacher. It's always our pit stops. It's always our pit stops. No point fighting Gasly, we're just gonna let him pass so that he can pull us to Schumacher with DRS.
Okay, we've lost a position, that's us down a place.
Why, Pierre? Making so many mistakes. Oops, cut a corner a bit. Let's have some fun with the AI. Oh man, here comes Gasly. No point fighting him. Oh, sorry. Oh, a bit too deep.
Good job, nice overtake. We're starting to catch the car in front, but we need to look after the tyres. We won't be making another pit stop. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by...
Oh, yellow flags.
0.6 seconds.
Yellow flags up ahead.
I've got some information on Alonso. Okay.
Oh man,
No. P12. Oh, could have scored our first points, man. Ah! Oh, man. So close yet so far.
Race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
Another excellent win from Ferrari. Talk to me, Ant. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Here come our winners now, a thrilling race and a tremendous effort by Ferrari. Their history is well known, so it's no surprise to fans the world over to see them come out on top once again.
Ah, no.
So let's review the driver's standings.
Our one chance to get points, we flopped it.
Extends his lead even further with this result.
Oh, okay, we're P13 in standings, P17. Okay, we're up to P8.
I have to give it to the Black Mamba. That was a commanding performance today.
Good drive, but obviously we could have done better.
Things are shaping up in the Constructors'
Championship.
Oh, God. Ferrari continues to extend the lead to the top of the table. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin.
Ah, horrible weekend, but at least better than finishing last after getting wheel spin in the third corner like Bahrain. So, 12th place better than nothing. Oh man, we have a field upgrade after a horrible weekend.
We need your input here. Not an easy choice, I know.
What is this? We have a new rival. Lance Stroll or Daniel Ricciardo? Stroll in an Aston Martin having worse pace than us. Ricciardo, however, is in a better car than us, like a little bit of a better car than us, I believe. But I don't know. Should we go for the safe option or the risky option? Stroll or Ricciardo? I think in future races, to be more realistic, I think we are gonna go with, let's just try to go for Ricciardo. Yes, he's our rival.
Thanks for dealing with that. The department appreciates it.
Where are McLaren in the R&D charts? McLaren are just right ahead of us in the R&D charts, alright. Okay, thankfully we can get this upgrade just before the Australian Grand Prix, so we should have a huge upgrade package coming before Australia. The power unit upgrade and durability upgrade should come before Imola, if they don't fail, obviously. Let's get another upgrade. Okay, we'll deal with the sponsorships later, but unfortunately that's the end of today's video. Be sure to like, subscribe and turn on any notifications in order not to miss any future uploads of my team and other categories. I'm the Fat Boy. Hopefully have a good day and I'll see you next time for the next F1/FIFA video, and goodbye.